How the work of Matisse is still inspiring great images today. Modern Masters is at 9. Now on BBC One and lighting up the BBC HD channel. No one wants to hang up those ruby slippers.
Have now closed and the results are in. Last night, Jenny flew the West End nest. Tonight, another Dorothy will bite the Kansas dust. But who will the Lord decide to save this time? Take cover, a whirlwind of emotion is about to be unleashed, hoping to sing their way into the semi-final. It's our Dorothys!
Something has changed within me. Something is I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for a second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and sleep. It's time to try defying gravity. I think
the sing-off and make it through to the semi-final. Will it be Steph, Lauren, Jessica, Sophie, or Danielle?
I'm through accepting limits, 'cause someone says there's no. Some things I cannot change, until I try.
Last night, our Dorothys sprinkled their magic over musical theatre classics, but they barely had time to rest their sparkly shoes before our first elimination struck. We said an emotional farewell to Jenny, who had to hand back her shoes to the Lord. He's got so many now, eventually he'll find a pair that fits. Shortly, we'll reveal which two Dorothys have received the fewest viewer votes, and we'll have to sing for a place in the semi-final in front of Andrew Lloyd Webber. Remember, he can only save one of them, the other will be flying out of the competition for good. Everyone is on tenterhooks tonight, not least our panel of experts. The legendary actress with the dazzling career, Sheila Hancock. Albert Square singing sensation, Dawn Partridge. The sizzling soprano from South Wales, Charlotte Church. And the man so powerful he can melt the wicked witch with one look. Lordy Lord, it's Andrew Lloyd Webber. Tonight, our Dorothys will be offering up another Spud We Hope You Like in our musical mashup. Tamsin Outwick will be here treating us to some sweet charity, and I predict a Rover riot as our totos are let loose on this very stage. Let's hope they don't leave anything behind. Plus, find out what happened when our canine auditionees went on a bonding session with our Dorothys. Was it a match made in doggy heaven?
about this six of you and this five dogs.
Are you going to be my crossguard here?
I think Tony should be quite friendly, so I think I'll be looking for something like that.
And the result of the kids' vote is...
We'll announce this week's top dog later. Last night, the Land of Oz was shaken by the departure of Jenny, and the Dorothys were sent into a spin. Here's a reminder of what happened. Oh, and welcome to Over the Rainbow!
I'm learning all my life.
Danielle, you have a real grace and sensitivity that I think would be wonderful for Dorothy.
You have a star quality.
That was just, like, extravagant and fun and frivolous. I really enjoyed it.
You'll never cease to make me smile.
Even if nothing comes of this competition, I made Andrew Lloyd Webber smile.
We'll find a new way of living.
I thought, Steph, that was absolutely wonderful.
I just hope that people pick up the phone and vote for you tonight.
You did really, really well.
Sorry, my dear.
Did it move me? Did it touch me? If I'm honest, no.
I completely disagree. I think there was just moments of real magic in that. I enjoy being a girl. I think you did it really well. Your vocal was absolutely spot on. I think you would have filled the theatre with that.
We're not just looking for a great vocal. We're looking for a great actress.
Yeah, but
we're looking
I think,
for huge personality.
I think,
would not fill or let the palladium.
Yeah, yeah. I think you filled the stage. You completely filled the stage. I loved it.
Somebody
Lauren, terrific. You're very professional.
Let's make no bones about it. You have the best voice in this competition.
You're vocally very, very strong.
Please welcome the fantastic Charlotte Church!
Back down to renounce the show.
One, Dorothy's dream is about to come to an end. Who will you save? Jenny or Lauren?
I'm going to save Lauren.
Just been another shock result. Really anybody's game right now. Doesn't that make it exciting?
It's our final five!
We're going to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. House began to glitch, the kitchen drink has slipped. Ding dong, the witch is dead, witch old witch, the wicked witch. Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of ta la la. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human.
Our Dorothys are all desperately hoping they've done enough to get through to next week's semi-final. But what did Andrew and the panel think? Andrew, you've already had to save one girl this weekend. Are you nervous about the result tonight?
One thing we've got to remember and pick up on something that Sheila said last night, comedy. Comedy, because if you think back on the old movie, a lot of the performers were vaudeville performers, and there's a lot of humour, and there's a lot of really quite knockabout comedy that in a big theatre like the Palladium, we're going to need. So the girl has got to be able to respond to those kind of very experienced comedians who we hope we'll have.
And Sheila, last night obviously we said goodbye to Jenny. Were you surprised by the bottom two?
Well, I mean, to be perfectly honest, everybody that's left has something very special about them that I love. So I'm jolly glad it's the audience that makes the decision, not me now. I really don't want to do any deciding.
And, John, this is a really crucial stage of the competition. It's just before the semi-final. How important is it these Dorothys hold their nerve?
It is incredibly important that they hold their nerve. As we can see, the bottom two is changing week on week. So each performance becomes more important than the last. Right now, it's anybody's game.
And Charlotte, Jenny left last night. The right girl to leave, do you think?
Well, I did say last night that Jenny wasn't my Dorothy on the night, and I think it was a tough song for her to sing, and she just didn't match up to the other girls, unfortunately, so maybe yes.
All right, well, thank you, panel. Now, until now, our talented Totos and delightful Dorothys have never met. But as potential co-stars, we thought it would be a good idea to see how they fared under the bright lights of Oz. So here they are, together at last. Please welcome our final five Totos and our final five Dorothys. first off on the doggy catwalk is Jessica and Dangerous Dave, a lovable dog who has a bad habit of stealing socks. Best keep those slippers on, Jessica. Next up, it's Danielle and Troy. Troy is particularly partial to sausages and can perform 10 doggy tricks, including bowing for our very own lord. Bow wow. Following Troy is Lauren and Eddie. Here they come. Eddie is a pug, Shih Tzu cross. Eddie's pastimes include barking at the television, catching mice, and shredding toilet rolls. Next up is Sophie and Missy. Crossbreed Missy is the only female mutt left in the competition. A flirtatious doggy diva with an eye for the boys, she's been described as the canine equivalent of Mariah Carey, only without the entourage. And finally, say hello to Stefan Spider. Playful Beagle Spider is an expert at hide and seek and has a passion for cheese. The smellier, the better. There they are, our top five Totos, everybody. Oh, so cute. Yes, so cute. So cute, but don't be fooled. They're all doggedly determined to win. They may look thick as thieves now, but when they all met up for their task earlier this week, did it all go to the dogs?
Today we've come to Richmond Theatre to see how the dogs bond with their fellow co-stars, Dorothy.
So, with their owners out of reach, could man's best friend become a friend of Dorothy's?
There's no business like...
Hiya, girls. Well, welcome to this week's Toto Task. Now, today, we're going to see how our dogs perform with you on stage as their co-stars. There's six of you and there's five dogs. So we're going to let them decide who they want to share a stage with, which means one of you will not get to perform.
Girls, you're going to call the dogs to you. Whoever the dog goes to first, that'll be their co-star. Dave, choose wisely. Your career may depend on this.
Dave's got Jessica. Oh, no, Dave changed his mind and gone for Sophie instead.
Congratulations.
And you're going to be my co-star, dear.
Four dogs still to choose. Five Dorothy's still to choose from. Eddie eventually picks Danielle. Troy takes a liking to... Steph.
Spider
scouts out... Jenny. Two girls left now, but only one dog remaining. It was down to Missy to make or break our Dorothy's day.
Wins. Well, may the best man win.
Best doctor win.
Oh, no. Lauren's missed Missy.
There was a bit of a sneaky move by Jessica, who sort of swung round to grab Missy as she sort of came back out of the wing.
So Missy picks Jessica, and Lauren's left out. It's the doghouse for her.
Maybe they could sense that I have cats at home.
So now the dogs have their Dorothy's. It was time for them to start bonding.
We need to believe that this is your best friend.
Eddie, Eddie, come. Eddie.
Bless you.
The ultimate test of their partnership lay ahead. Meet the critics of the future.
I'm a good critic because I know a lot of things.
The dogs have to be smart and they can do acting, not like normal dogs that are under control.
I think Toto should be quite friendly, so I think I'll be looking for something like that.
It's finally showtime, and first to display their onstage chemistry are Missy and Jessica.
Oh, Toto, come on!
Did she hurt you?
Oh, they're getting on well.
Why then, oh, why can't I?
Wonder if the biscuits are helping.
It went really well. She behaved really well.
Yay, more biscuits.
Toto, come.
Time for Eddie and Danielle.
Good boy, Toto. Good boy. Toto, up.
Oh. Very good.
Eddie seems to be turning into a bit of a stage dog.
I like Eddie because he has a funny face.
Next up, it's rescue dog Troy and Steph.
Toto! Come back, Toto! 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 Toto!
Bit of desperation in the voice there.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
We're so good together. I don't know what happened. What happened?
Let's see if Dangerous Dave and Sophie can do any better.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
Let's hope Dave could stay awake until the end of the song. Finally, it's our skating dogs, Spider and Jenny.
Come on, Toto!
Why, oh, why can't I?
A natural performer!
Spider, I think if he doesn't become Toto, I think he's definitely got a career in stand-up comedy.
The Totos have done everything they can, and in a week where the nation's gone voting crazy, we gave the kids a chance to have their say too.
Before you decide that the time's right for making your mind up.
With the votes cast, it's time to reveal which Pooch is the judges' and the kids' favourite.
The panel's top dog today is Spider. I was particularly bowled over by Spider's enthusiasm to get on the stage. I thought that was lovely.
And the result of the kids' vote is Dave.
Oh, it's lovely to know that the children chose Dave because I think he was a really deserving winner.
He's such a lovely dog and he's so affectionate. I think he's won everybody's hearts over already.
Oh, I want them more. Now, week after week, our Dorothys have dished up perfectly light and fluffy musical mashups. And tonight, our Kansas cooks have been busy creating a brand new one just for you. Andrew, can you handle getting mashed again?
I always add a little dash of olive oil.
A lovely idea. Mmm. We inform, we entertain. Here with another helping of mash, it's our Dorothys! Southwade will be performing a sweet charity classic, plus the second sing-off of the weekend looms. Another Dorothy will be leaving the competition. But first, with only 2 weeks to go until the final, our Dorothys can almost smell the musical air of Oz. But are they up to our panel's idea of perfection?
Danielle, I think, is a really strong contender in this competition. There's something about Danielle that just makes me think West End straight away.
Danielle has this very special quality. Whether she's Dorothy or not, she will be a big star.
I think she's got to retain what she's got, which is this unique quality, but somehow she's got to find a way of projecting it more without losing the subtlety.
When the show first started, I wasn't sure if she had that much personality, but I think she's really shown herself to be a consummate actress.
Sophie is so beautiful and she looks so different. She's also got one of the most natural voices in the competition. We just need to crack her shell a bit and I think she would be phenomenal.
She's nearly there. She's a bit sensible and I long for her to throw her bonnet over the windmills and be a zany redhead.
I fear it's nerves that pull you back a little bit. I want to kick you. I know it's there. There, it's there. Look.
I definitely think Sophie has it in her to play this role. I'm just not sure that she does.
Lauren was a bit too glib, and then she got knocked down to the sing-off. And after that, I thought she was totally transformed, and out came some true emotion.
Beautiful, it moved me deeply.
I think week on week she has delivered solid performances. You may not necessarily have liked that performance the most, but I think she is definitely the most professional and the most solid contender.
Her vocals are phenomenal. Her range is unbelievable. I would love to see her in the final.
That was one of the best performances I've ever seen in my life.
I think when the competition first started, Jess was your obvious choice as a musical theatre performer. But as the competition's gone on, I'm not really sure.
I just felt that there was no truth and no honesty in that performance at all.
She thinks of herself as being rather kooky and rather quirky. And I think she's got to be careful not to be saddled with that image.
I love her. Her facial expression is really overt, you know, you can really see it. So I think that sets her apart from the other girls. I think Steph's had a really tough journey in this competition. She's been knocked back by the public, and every week she's blown me away.
I just find you so engaged, and I cannot take my eyes off you.
She's never fazed. She'll come up with the goods, whatever you throw at her. She's an all-rounder. I mean, that's her strength.
That was absolutely wonderful. Sincere and honest.
I think Steph needs to step it up a level now. She's been brilliant, but it's hard to be brilliant every week. She just needs to keep pushing now, and she needs to believe that she can be Dorothy, because if she believes she can be Dorothy, that's what we're going to get.
Wise words from the panel there. But how do our Dorothys feel? Remember how squashed we used to be sitting here? Just yeah. The five of you now. It's very spacious. And, Steph, it's tense and emotional for everyone, but you are very resilient. You know, you've been in the bottom two, you had a very emotional song. Where do you get that kind of strength from?
I don't know, I've developed it from somewhere. I've had such a rocky ride in this competition, and I don't know, it's just, like, forced me to come out and be strong every week. I'm not even recognising myself at the moment. It's just, like, crazy, but I'm developing it from somewhere.
All right, and, Lauren, you know, John said you're the best voice in the competition, and yet there you were in the bottom two. You had amazing comments. Were you shocked to find yourself in that position?
I mean, obviously, I was devastated to be in the bottom two, but each week, none of us have any idea who those two are going to be, and I did have some wonderful comments, and I'm so thankful for that. I just hope that it's enough to save me from the bottom two again.
Jessica, for fact fans, the only Dorothy now not to have been in the bottom two. You must be doing something, right?
I think that's all down to like how fantastic my fan base are at home and across the UK. I just want to thank all the munchkins for supporting me, really. I wouldn't be here without them, so it's great.
Talking about the borough in a minute. I'll be lost. Cheers. Good luck to you all. Each week, our Dorothys are put through their performance paces. It's been a grueling competition, and they've worked their socks off, but somehow kept their slippers on. So we decided to give them a well-deserved treat and a taste of West End glamour. A night out at the opening of the musical Sweet Charity. Lucky things.
It's the opening night of Sweet Charity, and our Dorothys have been invited to get a taste of what their opening night might be like.
Absolutely crazy.
Next, a VIP ticket to meet the star of the show.
It was awesome meeting Tamsin again after the show. It
just makes us think about what our opening night could be like if we were the
Just sit there like... Just the buzz of an opening night, seeing what it's like. And that will happen for all of you in whatever job and whatever show. You'll always have an opening night somewhere. So make sure you remember that.
Just proves to me and confirms in myself how much I want to be a leading lady.
It inspired all of us, I think, and we just want it even more now.
Our darlings enjoyed a great night at the theatre. In fact, they enjoyed it so much, they wanted you to experience it as well. Here singing, If My Friends Could See Me Now, please welcome Tamsin Althwaite.
If they could see me now, that little gang of mine, I'm eating fancy chow and drinking fancy wine. I'd like those stumble bums to see far effect, the kind of top drawer first-rate chums I attract. All I can say is, wow, we look at where I am. Tonight I landed, pow, right in a pot of jam. What a setup, holy cow. They'd never believe it if my friends could see me now. I'd hear those thrift shop cats say, brother, get her draped on a bedspread made from three kinds of fur. All I can say is, wow, wait till the rip and ref. See just exactly how he signed his autograph. What a build-up, holy cow. They'd never believe it if my friends could see me now. If they could see me now, along with Mr. V, who's waiting on me like he was a maitre d'. I'd hear my body saying, crazy what gives. Tonight she's living like the other half lives. To think the highest brow, which I must say is he, should pick the lowest brow, which there's no doubt is me. What a step up, holy cow. They'd never believe it if my friends could see me now.
Tamsin.
That's a pleasure.
Now, obviously, you are a true friend of Dorothy. You've worked with the girls right from back in the audition stages.
Yep.
So what sort of progress or improvement can you see?
They're all doing so well. Their voices hold up. Their dancing's coming along. I'm just really proud of them all.
And congratulations. You just had your opening night in Sweet Charity.
Yes.
So what could our winner look forward to on her opening night?
Oh, lots of nerves. loads of adrenaline pumping through your body. But I would say that kind of, that rush of energy and adrenaline doesn't happen every night in the theatre. 8 shows a week for a whole year or however long. So make the most of the opening night because it's never that exciting again.
All right, listen, thank you very much. Tamsin Alzwaite, everybody. Soon, our second Dorothy will be leaving the competition. With the end of the rainbow in sight, our Dorothys are more determined than ever to land their dream role. But why did they think they deserve a place in the semi-final?
I deserve to be in the semi-finals because I have had such a rocky ride in this show and I've come back fighting every week and I just want to fight my way into the semi-finals.
I think I should be in the semi-final because I still feel like I've got an incredible amount to still give and I've come so far now and to leave at this stage in the competition would just be absolutely heartbreaking.
I should be in the semi-final because it is one step closer to my dream and to win the role of Dorothy would just change my life forever.
I think I should be in the semi-final because I always come back fighting. I've been knocked down a lot and I will do anything to be in the semi-final.
I think I should be in the semi-final because every week I pull something totally different out of the bag and I want to continue to do that.
So, which of our Dorothys have impressed you and earned a place in next week's live semi-final? Just 4 places available. The 2 Dorothys with the lowest number of votes must perform again in our sing-off. Andrew can only save one of them. There may be no place like home, but none of our girls want to go there tonight. 1. Dorothy's dream is about to come to an end. All the votes have been counted and verified. I will now announce the results in no particular order. Sophie. You could still be Dorothy. You're through to the semi-final. Congratulations. Please leave the stage. Danielle. You are in the bottom 2. I'm sorry. Come and join me, please. Lauren. You're through to next week's semi-final. Well done. And Jessica, please step forward. There is only 1 guaranteed place in next week's semi-final. Thanks to viewers' votes, one of you is safe and through to next week's live show. One of you is on very dangerous ground and in the sing-off with Danielle. Steph. You could still be Dorothy. Congratulations. Please join the others. Which means, Jessica, you are in the bottom 2. I'm sorry. Please wait there. Okay, it's Danielle and Jessica. One of you received the lowest amount of votes, and if it were down to viewers' votes alone, I can reveal the girl that would be out of the competition is Jessica. But Jessica, there's still hope. Andrew may decide to save you. They must both now perform Take That Look Off Your Face, a song Andrew wrote. He knows how every single note should sound. All of our Dorothys have been rehearsing it this week. None of them wanted to sing it tonight. Andrew, the last chance to convince you, what do they do?
Girls, this comes from a one-woman show I wrote called Tell Me on a Sunday, which you probably know. And it's the moment where one of your so-called best friends comes in with the bad news that she's seen your boyfriend with somebody else. But what you're saying is take that look off your face because I knew before, so don't you feel so proud of yourself about this. I want to feel proud of you tonight. You've got to think of the words. You're both terrific. You've given me the most dreadful dilemma, I think. But sing away. Go on.
All right. Thank you very much, Andrew. Danielle will perform first, followed by Jessica. Here, singing to impress Andrew Lloyd Webber and win his casting vote. It's Danielle and Jessica.
He's doing some deal up in Baltimore now. I hate it when he's away. You must be mistaken. I'm sure that you are. There's more than one car with stickers on. And lots of young guys wear corduroy pants. And I'd know if he hadn't gone. Take that look off your face. Take that look off your face. I can see through your smile. I can see through your smile. You would love to be right. I bet you didn't sleep good last night. Couldn't wait to bring all of that badness to my door. Well, I've got news for you. I knew before. Mistaken, it started last year. I'm not very clear how it began. I noticed the change, but I just closed my eyes as only a woman can. No, I didn't dig deep. No, I didn't dig deep. I did not want to know. I did not want to know. Well, you don't. Scared of the things you might hear. When he's back, you think I will end it right there and then. Well, my fair weather friend, you're wrong again. Take that look off your face. Take that look off your face. I can see through your smile. I can see through your smile. You would love.
Audience standing. It was a gorgeous performance for both of you. You've done all you can. It's now up to Andrew. Andrew, Danielle or Jessica? Who will you save?
You sure have done all you can. Both of you are really, really terrific girls. No point in my saying that again. We've talked about so much and we asked the public to think also about everything you've done over the last few weeks. And there's no question that both of you will go on to other things, but I have to make one decision tonight, as I fear you know. I'm just thinking of Dorothy here. Not necessarily your talent, really. Well, it is your talent, but I'm really thinking of the role of Dorothy. So, I'm going to save Danielle.
Congratulations, Danielle. You're through to next week's semi-final. Go and join the others. I'm so sorry. What did it come down to, Andrew?
I'm going to say this is the heaviest heart in the entire world, and we've just seen Tamsin do, if they could see me now, and I've seen you do that very song. And, you know, that's exactly the kind of role I really, really see you in. I'm just a little bit unsure about Dorothy, but you know, you're so wonderful and quirky. We've got it's funny girl, it's something like that.
Yeah, I love
you,
that anyway.
You are a real, real star in the making.
Thank you.
Oh, so close to the semi-final. That must be really, really disappointing.
Do you know what? I I've had the best experience of my life so far. And you know, I've got an opportunity to go and train in September, and that's where I think that I'm going to go, unless something major comes up. I'm going to train. And these girls are all fantastic, and I swear to God, it's changed my life. It's made me grow as a person and as a performer, and I've just loved every minute of it. I've loved standing and singing in front of the Lord and the fabulous panel every week. And you know what? These girls, I just can't wait to go and see one of them on stage.
Oh, well, we love you being here. We love getting to know you. You've done yourself proud. You really, really have. Yeah. But it is time to say goodbye. Yeah, you know what's coming.
Yep.
It's time to hand back those shoes. So if you want to join the other Dorothys to sing us out of the show one last time, there she is, Jessica, everybody. Jessica is out of the competition. Now, Danielle, Steph, Sophie and Lauren will battle it out in our live semi-final next Saturday at 7:10 here on BBC One. Plus, our Totos get a musical makeover as they prepare for a very special scene-stealing task. Until then, I'll leave you with Jessica and our Dorothys to say goodbye in their own special way.
Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are.